Hey, I thought I'd show you how to make what we call a sleeping burrito. So here in Utah, we get a lot of snow up in the mountains, feet of snow, 5, 10 feet of snow in some cases, and it can be really powdery and deep. And that's not really, when you're doing winter camping, that's not a lot of fun to set up a tent in that scenario. But the thing I most dislike about the tent side is when I come home, then I've got a wet tent, and there's really no way to avoid that. So we always set it up in the garage, and then you got to park outside for several days while the tent dries out, and then you go and you roll it up. So it's just a tremendous hassle. So somebody came up with the idea of what we call the burrito, and that's what we common thing in the scouts around here. So just want to show you how to do that. So first of all, I've got some plastic here. This is 3.5 mil, 10 by 25 sheet I got at Home Depot. So you don't need 25 feet, but you do need the 10. So what I suggest is you cut off 10 feet of that. You could do 8. That wouldn't be bad, especially for a kid. But for a man's sleeping bag and all that, probably 10 by 10 is the best way to go. So you'll cut that out, you lay that down, then you're gonna lay down a piece of this space blanket. Now, this one's a little bit thicker. It's got kind of a backing to it, so it won't tear up. If you use the ones in the emergency kit, I think that it'd probably ball up on you. It probably wouldn't work as great. So anyway, take one of those, then you're gonna lay down a pad. This is a pad that I got at Home Depot. Pretty dense foam, and they also sell the canvas zip-up bags that go around them. They're kind of a pain to get in the bag, but it works once you have it. Then the next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna have your sleeping bag. So this is a negative 50 degree grizzly sleeping bag. It doesn't have to be a negative 50. You'd be probably fine with like a negative 20. It doesn't have to be a real big one or a mummy sack or whatever. So there I've got three layers, four: plastic, the space blanket, the foam pad, and then the sleeping bag. Next, I'm going to add another sleeping bag, and this is absolutely essential. You need another real sleeping bag, not just one of the liners. This is probably a 20 degree sleeping bag. So it's thick, but you'd freeze to death if that's all you had. So you're going to take this one and you'll put that in the inside, like so. Then, if you want, you can always have your pillow there. You're going to want something. Now, at this point, I've got it all ready. I just need to seal it up. So I'm going to take this plastic that's already, a 10 by 10 square, and I'm just going to fold that over, like so. And then I'm going to use duct tape to seal it up. Now, that side has got the fold, so you don't need duct tape there, but you will need it on the bottom, and you'll need it on this side over here. Now, the question you're going to have is, how do you actually set this in the ground and you're going to use it? So first of all, you get the deep snow. What you'll do is, I recommend, you can either stamp or you can use a shovel, but get yourself kind of a bathtub type shape that you cut into the snow. The bottom should be somewhat firm. And then the deeper it is, the less you're going to have to worry about wind. And you actually have a pretty insulated situation there, just kind of like you would with an ice cave or a snow cave. So you're going to go ahead and set this down in that. And then, if you look over here, as you're getting into it, that can be kind of the tricky part. So you can go ahead and seal this all the way up to the top, but you can also leave like maybe a foot out. Then you can just kind of fold it like that. Now I'm standing on my plastic. I'm ready to go to bed, but I have my ski coat, ski bibs or ski pants, and I got my winter boots on. All of that's probably got little bits of ice and snow on it. I don't want to get in there with that. So what I'll do is I'll have some sleeping clothes if I don't have, thermals on, or if my thermals are wet, I wouldn't want to get in here like that. But have some thermal underwear or long sleeve shirts or something inside. But you're going to take your clothes off here, okay? So take your boots off, set them there. Then your jacket and such. And then you're going to climb in. Now, when you're in there, you're going to have more room than you think. So you can kind of turn around and on your hands and knees. And this is from inside. You'll put your boots like that so that you've got some ventilation. Now, I don't think that's particularly necessary. You're going to have some ventilation no matter what, just because unless you were to really seal it up. But, you know, put your coats and such in here. You do not want your boots on the outside. You wake up in the morning, they'll be full of snow, and they'll be full of ice, and they'll be, you know, those will be frozen. It's no fun to put those on. So make sure those are underneath. If you're a little bit claustrophobic, which I never realized that would be a problem, like, till I built an ice cave, and the ceiling of the ice cave was like 3 inches from my nose. You know, if you're a little claustrophobic, go ahead and use clear. Now, the thicker the plastic you use, the better. Not because you're going to get a lot of different insulation factor out of it, but it does tear really easy. And so, you know, it'd be nice to go ahead and not have to worry about that quite so much. Now, after you're done here, you're just going to roll it up and put a piece of rope around it, tie it off. Now, it's going to be big. It's going to be probably this big around. And so each of your scouts that are doing this, they can have a lot. Now, it'll fill up the back of a pickup truck pretty easily. But nevertheless, you'll be all set. You get to your campsite, dig your trench, roll it out, and you'll be warm. That's it. Good luck.